Now the Lord is that Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty. But we all, with open face, beholding as in a glass the glory of the Lord, are changed into the same image from glory to glory, even as by the Spirit of the Lord. Our modern day concept of ministry is so corrupted. We think of ministry only as a career, ordained, licensed men, women who marry and bury. They pastor churches, they build and maintain institutions, and we think of the ministry as someone who's gone to seminary or Bible college and comes out and some denomination or some organization ordains or licenses that individual. We say he is in the ministry. That is not a biblical concept, not at all. No human being, no bishop, no denomination can put you in the ministry. They can give you a paper, but that does not make you a minister of the gospel. And folks, God doesn't judge ministry by effectiveness, by magnitude. Paul speaks of a ministry that every single one of us listening to me today have been called to. Paul says it's a calling that every born-again believer has been called to undertake. It's our first calling. It's a ministry out of which all other godly endeavors are birthed. It's called the ministry of beholding the face of Christ. To spend quality time in the presence of Jesus, just beholding. That's quietly worship. It's dedicated, focused worship. It's time given to Him just beholding His face. This word beholding is a very serious and strong word that the apostle used. It's not just taking a look, but in the Greek, it's fixing the gaze. It's making a decision that I will not move from this position. This is my calling. Before I do anything else, before I try to attempt anything for God, I've got to come out of His presence. I've got to come out with something that I've received in His presence that is changing me. I have been changed. I have not gotten this in a seminary. I have not gotten this from man. I got this along with Jesus, beholding His face. I have fixed my gaze on Him. I said, this is going to be my life. If my life is to count, I'm not going to sit around saying, what can I do with my life? I'm not going to try to figure out what I can do as a career, for a career. I am going to do the one thing God has called us all to do. Get alone with Him, stay in His presence, worship, behold His face. It's the face of Jesus. Paul talked about the glory of God in the face of Jesus. It's spending that quality time beholding His face, and as if we were looking into a glass, only as if we were looking. In other words, we are studying, we are looking, we are fixing a gaze, not just a passing glance. He becomes the center and the obsession of your life. You know that you can't get what you need any other place. It's into the presence of the Lord. And the Bible said those who spend time beholding Him are transfigured. They are changing. It's the opening up of the heart and the mind to Jesus until every time you come into His presence, there's a change. You may not feel it, you may not see it, others may not see it right away, but there's a more metamorphosis taking place. There's a change. Something is happening. The glory of the Lord is being manifest when you spend time alone with the Lord. And I think that's the first thing that happens when you behold Christ in His glory. Begin to see how short of that glory you've come and how blind you've been. How blind you've been. But it has to be a continual thing because the changes are continual. Now, beloved, before I close, I want to tell you something. Everybody in this building, everyone hearing the sound of my voice, we're all changing. One way or another, we're changing. You are in the process of changing. There's a transfiguration taking place in all of our lives. Our character is formed and changed by what obsesses us. Whatever is your whatever you whatever has your heart, wherever your eyes are fixed, the one thing that you're going after, that's going to form your character. Whatever you're feeding your soul on is changing you. It's affecting you. We're all being changed, the scripture says. Slothful, lazy Christians. One thing I dread more than anything else, if anything puts the fear of God in my heart, just having a long period of ease where there's no demands made upon me, I become lazy. I'm not into the Word, and I don't have that time of beholding His face. Then I know that the growth is stopped. And I want to tell you, you start going back the other way. And I tell you, you can lose the very vision until the face of Jesus just begins to fade away. I would rather die. I don't ever want that to happen in my life. So God, do whatever you have to do to keep me on my face in the Holy of Holies. If you're going through a hard time now, if you're facing a trial, the Lord has just put you in the ministry. So be careful. The scripture says, do not bring an offense to that ministry by turning into a sniveling, complaining coward. You see, you have to prepare. You have to have the character before the impact. So now, the call to this church and all God's people, prepare your heart. Your ministry now is to get alone and behold my face, worship me, get to know me, and you'll be ready for anything. And out of that will come this outshining, this ministry of outshining, peace and rest and joy in the Holy Ghost. And folks, the time is coming. Many of you are going to fall apart because you have not been beholding His face. That's your ministry. That's mine. When I get to heaven, the Lord, when He opens a book, He's not going to be talking about any building that I was enabled to build or any institution. He's not going to talk about any of the crusades. He's not going to talk about that. He's going to talk about the outshining. He will talk about the character. He's going to talk about how I responded. You came here this morning carrying anguish and trepidation of fear. It may be a financial disaster that's looming ahead of you. Some of you may be facing a situation. You say, I don't know how I'm going to take it. I don't want it to overwhelm me. I'm telling you, if you love the Lord, you've been walking with Him, you may think that you'll fail. You may think that you won't have it. But sometimes I've seen some of the most fragile, most tender people become like Gibraltar's Rock of Ages. Because the Holy Spirit came and gave strength they didn't know was possible for them to have. Lord Jesus is meant to produce Christ-likeness in us. For everything that comes into our lives, if we're in trust with You, if we're walking with You, and we're just loving You and resting in Your promises and Your Word, we need not fear what happens around us or to us, because You said You have everything under control.